By practicing these words, I can tell you your English pronunciation will skyrocket. Here are 20 pairs of similar yet confusing words that you can use to finally get rid of that poor pronunciation of yours. Number one, lot and not. The word lot in English is generally used to talk about a large number of things. For example, I ate a lot of food. I say that quite often. Additionally, in American English, it might be used to talk about a piece of land, usually for sale.
Is that really
Dumbledore?
Any study?
Pacing?
Does that a lot?
Not is used to refuse or negate something. For example, I am not feeling well today.
Hmm. Do they go to bed when they're told?
Well, no.
These words sound the same, except for their first consonants, L and N. Number two, flight and fight. As a verb, flight refers to the action of flying. It can also refer to a trip in a plane, such as, my flight leaves at 2 p.m. Fight, on the other hand, means to be violent with someone.
You've come to fight as free men. And free men you are.
The main difference between these two is the consonant L in the word flight. Number three, lit and let. Lit is the past tense of the word light. It means to burn something like a candle or a cigarette. Lit can also be used as an adjective to say that something is full of light, such as a room.
Hey, what do you got? Did you see what happened here?
You know what? Bottle rocket meets paper dragon in this Asian festival and lit it up like a birthday cake.
We got swamped with calls saying it was a real dragon.
Let is a synonym of allow, to allow something.
Let's vanish.
Engage retroreflection panel.
The vowel in the middle is what differentiates these words. The word lit rhymes with fit or kit, and let sounds more like get. Number four, pat and bat. To pat someone is to lightly touch them with the flat surface of your hand. Pat can also mean a piece of something that is very soft, like butter.
This is gonna be the best book ever.
Not to pat myself on the back, but yes, it probably will be. Here we go.
Bat is usually a long wooden thing used in sports like cricket or baseball. It's also a kind of bird that flies at night.
Yeah, come on, come on.
Put the bat down, put the bat down.
These words might sound very similar, but the P in pat sounds slightly harder than the B in bat. When you say pat, some air will come out of your mouth. But when you say bat, this won't happen. Number five, sip and zip. To sip something is to drink something slowly.
One sip and you will find that all of your endeavors succeed.
Zip, as a noun, is a short word for zipper, the thing that you use to close your pants or your jacket. As a verb, it means to close a zipper.
All right, zip it.
You can't even...
Zip it! Zip.
I have found that a great way to learn and practice English pronunciation is through watching videos. And one of my favorite apps for learning a language with videos is FluentU. FluentU turns music videos, movie trailers, music, and even inspiring talks into immersive language learning lessons for you. This makes FluentU the perfect app for practicing pronunciation and identifying these tricky words I am teaching you today, since you can hear them spoken by various native speakers in authentic ways. And because you're watching this video, I left a link in the description where you can try FluentU for 2 weeks absolutely free. And who doesn't love free stuff, right? All right, now let's continue with our next set of words. Number six, writer and writer. A writer is someone who writes, usually for a living.
Why does the writer use these lines?
Because he's in a hurry.
No! Ding! Thank you for playing anyway.
And a rider, with just an R, is someone who rides an animal or a vehicle. This is commonly used in the context of riding a horse.
Where's your rider? Rapunzel. Rapunzel!
What is interesting in this pair is that even though the first letters are different, the first sounds are the exact same. The consonants in the middle, T and D, make them different in terms of pronunciation. Number 7, we have pen and pan. A pen is a thin, small tool used to write and draw.
We were expecting an exploding pen. We don't really go in for that anymore.
A pan is a circular, flat utensil used to cook foods like eggs.
Out of the frying pan.
And into the fire. Run. Run!
The vowel in the middle differentiates these two. The E resembles the vowel in hen or ent. Meanwhile, the A sounds the same as the one in hand. Number 8. Tease and knees. To tease someone is to playfully make fun of someone.
Oh, Mr. Bennett, how can you tease me so? Have you no compassion for my poor nerves?
Knees are the joints in your leg that connect your upper and lower legs.
We have a T-Rex.
Well,
put your head between your knees.
Dr. Grant, my dear Dr. Sattler.
Even though their spellings are completely different, they sound very similar. The second part of both these words sound like E's, but the first part of T's sounds more like T, and the first part of knees sounds more like knee because the K is silent. Number 9 is tie and lie. As a verb, tie means to join two things with a knot using a string or a rope. As a noun, it refers to the piece of clothing that men usually wear around their necks when dressing formally.
Is he ever dressed like this?
No. Jacket and tie.
To lie is either to say something false or to be in a horizontal position, like when you're lying in bed.
You okay, kid?
Yes, sir.
The difference, of course, is the first consonant in each word. Number 10, we have arrive and alive. To arrive is to get to a place.
You're late.
A wizard is never late, Frodo Baggins. Nor is he early. He arrives precisely when he means to.
To be alive is to have life. The middle sound in both words will help you separate these pairs. Other than the R and the L sounds, these two words sound exactly the same. Number 11, grow and glow. To grow is to become larger over time.
An idea is like a virus, resilient, highly contagious. And the smallest seed of an idea can grow. It can grow to define, destroy you.
To glow means to shine or to create light in a dark place.
Seen a bit of mileage and you've got the glow stick of destiny. Would you like a drink?
In terms of sounds, it's quite easy to separate them since the last part of both the words are spelled as they are written. The end of each word sounds like O. Like the previous pair, the R and the L consonants are what make them different. Number 12, sigh and thigh. To sigh is to take a deep breath as a sigh of sadness, relief, or tiredness. Like.
I think that door just sighed.
The thigh is the part of your leg that is above your knee.
One guy just wanted to buy his wife a pair of thigh highs.
Since both these words have such different meanings, it is easy to differentiate them. The S in sigh sounds like the hiss of a snake, and the th in thigh sounds like the end of the word tooth. Number 13, cut and cat. To cut is to make an opening or create two or more pieces of something using a sharp tool.
I'm gonna cut out your heart and take it to my father. I am a Viking!
A cat, of course, is an animal.
Oh my God, what is?
What the hell is that?
It's a cat.
That is not a cat.
Yes, it is. The middle sound in cut is pronounced as a. And in cat, it's pronounced as a. Number 14, pin and bin. A pin is a small, sharp metal object used to fasten cloth or paper. It can also refer to the act of pushing someone to the ground or a wall holding them there.
It's gonna be great. There's a big ceremony and all the dads come and they pin on our badges.
A bin is a narrow basket-like object. In British English, a bin is a place where you put trash. First consonant is what makes these words different. Like with pat and bat, you can practice by seeing if air comes out of your mouth when you say pin and not when you say bin. Number 15, tent and tenth. A tent is a temporary shelter made from cloth or wood.
Can I tell you a secret?
No.
All right, here it goes. I never actually built a tent before. There, I said it.
Tenth can refer to the number 10 in a series. For example, the 10th house on a street.
The 10th man.
The final sound is what makes these words different. The T at the end of tenth is a hard T sound. The F at the end of tenth sounds like the end of the word tooth. Number 16, we have sheer and cheer. Sheer is a word that is used to emphasize an adjective. For example, the president's speech was sheer nonsense. Sheer can also refer to a kind of cloth that is so thin that you can almost see through it.
For sheer dumb luck.
Cheer, on the other hand, is encouraging someone by making loud noises and exaggerated gestures, like at a sporting event. I'm sure you've all seen that. To differentiate between the two, you need to focus on the first sound. The ch of cheer is pronounced similar to the ch of cherry. The sh in sheer sounds like the sound you make to tell someone to be quiet, like sh. Number 17, we have bowling and boring. Bowling is a sport played with huge balls and pins.
And I will make sure that you walk funny for the rest of your miserable last days on earth!
Tough spare, Slick.
You messed with the wrong head!
His head is a little...
Boring means the same thing as uninteresting. Like, this class is boring.
Move! He's asleep! He's boring.
The L and the R sounds make them different. Every other part of the word is pronounced in the same way. Number 18, kneel and near. To kneel is to bend on your knees.
I said,
kneel!
Something is near to you when it is close to you physically.
She shot an arrow at your head.
Well, at an apple.
Near your head.
The K in kneel is silent, so the first consonants of these words actually sound exactly the same. The last parts of the words are a bit different, though. These parts are pronounced just like the words eel and ear. Number 19, hard and heart. If something is hard, it is either physically solid or it's very difficult to do.
Tents are hard.
The heart is an organ in our body that constantly pumps our blood.
Break her heart?
In half.
Crush her soul?
Like a grape.
The different sounds of D and T in these words make them sound different. Finally, our last word pair is number 20, bent and vent. If something is bent, it's kind of curved at an angle. It's bent.
There is no spoon.
Then you'll see that it is not the spoon that bends, it is only yourself.
A vent can be an opening in a wall that lets gases pass through a room. The word can also be used as a verb, meaning to let out strong emotions.
You got broad gauge iron bars on every door, vent, and window.
The B and V are what makes these words sound different. One way to practice is to watch what you do with your mouth while saying these words. When you say bent, your two lips come together at the beginning, bent. When you say vent, you'll put your upper teeth on your bottom lip. If you want to review all these word pairs, be sure to download the free FluentU PDF in the description box below. This PDF also contains other information that I didn't cover in this video. And if you want more authentic material that's going to help you sound more native and fluent in English, be sure to press on the video over there. It's a goldmine of information, and I think you'll really enjoy it. We'll see you over there.